Ever since Biden became president, he's taking a lot of executive actions. And then we see the liberal news media making a hype about it. And already there's some scary actions taking place and some dreadful fears about what's going to happen to the future of our country. So let's go through all these issues on what's going on. First of all, you might remember about the thousands of guardsmen that were called upon during Biden's presidency. And I don't know if you've heard about this, but this is from Politico. As soon as the presidency, the inauguration was over, guess what happened to these thousands of guardsmen? Because, you know, we've got to get to go to war, and not a single war broke out or happened. Because everyone was so scared about these Trump rioters that something big was going to happen. But then in the title of their article from Politico, "We feel incredibly betrayed. Thousands of guardsmen forced to vacate Capitol." A lot of them were stuck in the parking building. Because after the inauguration, here we are, we're useful and ready. And then, what? They're just doing nothing after that. You just left them out. Good thing they didn't leave them out to die or something like that, since they're the military. But you notice that these Democratic leaders, they make a big hype about something, over-dramatize things, and then you let other people suffer consequently as a result. A lot of you may have heard about this one at the Vatican. This is from Reuters, title of their article, "Former Head of Vatican Bank Guilty of Embezzlement, Money Laundering." So that was a big scandal going on at the Vatican. But guess what? The money that the Vatican's involved with, especially if you study some things about Vatican banking and the bankers and the globalists, it becomes disturbing issues. And they're actually pivoting this. I don't know if you've all heard about this group, but there's a group of bankers, and they're become a very powerful force. And they're actually, I forgot the name of their organization, but the title of from the New York Times article is "Fed Joins Climate Network to Applause from the Left." For some of you who don't know, the name of this organization to watch out for now, where you're going to see powerful globalists and people involved, is called the Network of Central Banks and Supervisors for Greening the Financial System. And actually, this includes some of the big globalist leaders talking about the Great Reset. And what's kind of disturbing is that some of these bankers who are involved with this organization talking about the Great Reset. And I know, I don't know if you remember from my previous teachings when I've told you about the World Economic Forum, when they were discussing about what this Great Reset will be like. Where basically we're all prone to a technological system dependent upon this organization and technology to minister things for us. So basically individuality has gone out of the window more and more. So we'll take care of you. But now the feds, the Federal Reserve is now joining this network of central banks now. So that's pretty bad now. So now we're seeing where the federal system is getting involved with these globalists pushing the green agenda. So look at this. This has gotten to a point where you got to be focusing on giving people jobs and helping out their economy. But imagine that all these huge bankers and globalists, they concentrate instead the money on what? The earth is dying and we got to rescue on that one. Now, obviously, we're not condoning about burn the earth and burn every green vegetable you find out there. But for crying out loud, the devil, you see what he's doing? He's trying to get them involved on issues that seem like, ooh, a big issue to take care of, but they're very minute and minor in comparison. For example, about the coronavirus situation. Sure, you know, we have to be careful about that, but they concentrated so much about that the economy has crashed. And I told you in previous videos, that's China's goal, that they cannot win a war against them. So the only war they can win against them is economically. And I showed you in the previous videos about end times that China became now a leading factor where all the countries and nations and the stupid, idiotic liberal news media said, things we can learn from China on how they handle things. See, that's the devil's goal and system now. is to get rid of the individuality and the economic power, where now the people, they can become dependent upon some type of more of a socialist program. Now you got the Fed involved with this one. So this is pretty disturbing. In fact, if you go to ngfs.net, if you go over there, look at all these powerful organizations and bankers, and you're going to drop your jaw. So you can look up at their website. Look at membership section of ngfs.net, these guys. I think they're another group of globalists to watch out for in the coming years. I really believe the devil's going to use this green agenda. And he's already using the virus agenda, where it's gotten to a point where the economy is like being crumbling more and more and more and more. So then it's making our country losing its individual status and becoming more of a socialistic perspective now. It's becoming more of a socialistic perspective where they're going to join other countries and they're going to depend upon the government to give them a way out. But it's already doing a great job. People already rely on the government now. So then what about these vaccines that we're dependent on the government about? Well, I mean, the conspiracy, you've heard the conspiracy theorists telling you, what if that you have this vaccine and then what if it goes to a different type of vaccine and then a different type of system? And God forbid, now you're going to the mark of the beast. Oh, it won't happen. This virus will be over as soon as we take the vaccine. Title of the article from CNBC. Dr. Fauci says new data shows COVID vaccines appear to be less effective against some new strains. Before they said that this vaccine, I told you before in the previous videos that they said before that it should be okay with the new strains. Now Dr. Fauci is saying it's becoming less effective. Oh my. I told you so, right? Told you so. Just wait in time. Just wait in time, and then it's going to get heavier and heavier. God forbid, we're going to hit the mark of the beast real soon. Title of the Markets Insider article, in their business article, this is troubling. Legendary investor Jeremy Grantham says Biden's $1.9 trillion stimulus plan would make the stock market bubble even worse. Wow. Why? Because the government needs to give more of a handout to help these people. Now, I have to admit, compared to the previous bill, remember that previous bill that the stupid Republicans were talking about? That it was so ridiculous that even conservatives and the liberal news media were speaking out against it. So it might be better than that one, but it still doesn't change the fact, like the beginning coronavirus relief package, that we've gotten to a point we've become dependent upon the government. It's got to be jobs. It's got to be work. But no, they keep closing it off now. That's why China's leading the way. So the new vaccine that they're thinking about using is, this is from Market Watch. The title of their article is Fauci suggests Johnson & Johnson COVID-19 vaccine could win emergency use authorization in just 2 weeks. So another company with their vaccine is coming out. It's gotten to a point that obviously a lot of people are speaking out, and one of them is actually a nurse, and this person kept his mouth shut, and he is not against vaccines actually. But then COVID injections start to come out, he claims, so I'm saying from his claim, obviously I don't know what's really going on behind the scenes, but this person, he says that he is not against vaccines and he kept his mouth shut, and then he was helping during the time when COVID injections were spreading, being a CNA nursing home worker himself, but now he couldn't stand it anymore because he claimed in title of this article from vaccineimpact.com, because obviously it's not going to be voiced out in mainstream news, obviously. Title of the article, CNA nursing home whistleblower. Seniors are dying like flies after COVID injections. Speak out. So there are some people claiming about that a lot of people are dying like flies. But remember about that Kaiser source that I used? And that's a highly factual source where they mentioned about there were allergic reactions, and even mainstream news articles were talking about that for some weird reason there were people dying after the vaccine shots. But this is another one, and this has been pretty big now. And they're still investigating. All the other deaths, they've been using fact checkers to say it doesn't relate to vaccine. It doesn't relate to vaccine, which is not a surprise to me. Mainstream news media always hype about that. They're not going to say it relates to vaccines ever. They're never going to do that. But this is one article from USA Today that they're still under investigation. So this has not been fact checked by the liberals yet to debunk it. Title of the article from USA Today, Death of Florida Doctor After Receiving COVID-19 Vaccine Under Investigation. And actually, if you read that article, the doctor, he was not against vaccines. And then he was using it himself even, but then died. And then the wife got bitter and mad and blamed the vaccines. So they're still investigating what really caused his death. Other news about what's going on in our world. Did you know that pregnant women, they're not recommended to take the vaccine shots? So that's why people are being very careful about this. This is from Wall Street Journal. Title of their article, WHO recommends most pregnant women don't use Moderna, Pfizer vaccines. You know why? Because I read their scientific research papers on the samples of the people and the population that they used. But they mentioned here that they did not use pregnant women. Now, I could be wrong, unless my research is wrong about that. But they mentioned that Pfizer admitted, and some of these big vaccine organizations admitted, they did not use pregnant women as part of their sample. So that's why they're not recommending pregnant women to do that. But you know what's even more disturbing is that because of what happened at Norway, remember that one? I mentioned a brief article title about that. Because of what happened at Norway, some of the people, they were concerned because in the sample, they mentioned that the average people that they were sampling was actually, if I recall from memory, well, it is definitely not elderly people. That wasn't the average sample. It was, to my memory and knowledge, if I recall, because I read tons of articles, it's around 50-year-olds. So that's been more of the average sample. So then after that thing that happened at Norway, they were very, very concerned. They're like wondering, maybe there's something going on with the vaccine. So, I mean, if you take graduate school class and study research papers, and I've done this, so it is a job where there has to be a committee to investigate it. And if you look at, now this is funny, but if you actually look at the website of the people who mention, such as WHO, it's interesting that these organizations, when you read them, especially the scientific research papers that they show about the actual statistics and the methods they use in the vaccines. So I read it, and then, yeah, they mention about the average age. Yeah, it was like the middle-aged person's 50-something. Although elderly people were included in it, but that wasn't the average. So that wasn't the average. But they mention at the end that caught my attention really well that even if basically, so I'm giving a rough interpretation, basically related to vaccine or not, if there's an adverse effect that happens, that you should let us know about that. So then, well, I don't understand why the news media, they make a big hype and then the social networks about trying to stamp it out. I mean, if this is supposed to be, because there's supposed to be a committee that investigates about is it really related to vaccines or not? Now, obviously, as we can guess, is that the committee investigated and their excuse is that basically, or their explanation is that it does not relate to vaccines, because their explanation is that because millions are taking the vaccines and these are elderly people, if we look at the toll of elderly people dying, there's no significant addition of more elderly people dying. So it's just a normal rate. So basically, the elderly people who died after receiving the vaccines, it's just basically coincidence. It's just basically a normal thing. They just died out of deaths that do not relate to vaccines, some type of elderly-related deaths that elderly people normally go through. So that's their explanation, that's their excuse. Now, one thing that troubles me, which is I'm still having a hard time finding the document of who are the exact people involved in this committee and their discussion of why they can rule it out in that way. What I'm asking is, I am concerned I have my right, because, look, there are people and elderly people who are taking vaccines and our loved ones who take vaccines. We have a right to know. We're talking about our lives here. So why not give us the information about that one? I don't know why I can't find that. Maybe they will later on. Who knows? I don't know. But here's the most famous death that people were fact-checked, that the liberal news media tried to do a fact-check on. Title of this article from USA Today, Fact Check: Not likely that COVID-19 vaccine was cause of Hank Aaron's death. So for some of you who don't know, Hank Aaron, he has a legacy as a former Braves baseball player. And he took the vaccine to demonstrate that, see, I can take it, nothing bad happened to me, but approximately 2 weeks later he died. So that obviously made a lot of people very scared, and they're like, look, see, this is, I told you, the vaccines, I don't trust this stuff, and look what's going on. So then they did a fact check about this, and they did the same thing like how they explained away Norway. Like, it's just a common elderly death, and then la-di-da-di-da, stuff like that. That's what they did. But what concerns me about it is, it's just too much of a coincidence that a person who demonstrates, see, nothing bad will happen to me, all right? We're not talking about millions of people. It could have been millions of people who could have died, right? But it had to be that one person out of some sheer coincidence that says, see, nothing bad will happen to me, and then just died like that. So you don't think that me as a person might go, I might be a little worried. I might be a little worried. We're not talking about like millions of people of statistics of elderly people dying, so this is a normal routine. Then for some weird reason, it had to hit that guy, Hank Aaron. And then there's still the previous investigations that they're doing with, I believe, the Florida doctor that I mentioned earlier, and etc. So we do have rights to be concerned, and you guys have the burden. Just like you mentioned, you have to have a burden of proof to point out that there's a fraud in the election, etc. You guys also have to have the burden to calm the public's concerns. That is your job. You have to prove it. You can't just we can't just rely on people's words like that. We want to see the statistics. We want to see the explanations and everything. By the way, even if you do get vaccines, all right, and that's a good thing, BBC News, title of the article, COVID, vaccinated people may spread virus, says Van Tom. Wow, so you don't think that I get angry then? Don't you think that we have a right to be angry about what's going on, that, hey man, like, we have to follow whatever government so-and-so says, and we don't have freedom to do things. We just have to depend and rely on whatever they say, because we're not going to be free even if we get these vaccines. Yeah. Man, that's our anger, and that's our frustration and concern. If I'm wrong, then you need to prove that. Don't just build up our suspicion higher. My word, man. By the way, you want to hear how bad this is? Okay, it's this bad, all right? CNBC, title of their article, is a double mask really better than a single? Is double mask really better than a single? Guess what? Some of you don't know this. Fauci says, according to USA Today, title of article, are two masks better than one? Double masking just makes common sense to help prevent COVID-19 spread, Fauci says. Oh my word. Okay, look. I get it, all right? I get it that, you know, there are scientific journals that talk about, you know, mask better than no mask. Okay, I get that. And then logically, double mask, all right? But look, even Fauci said this, okay? Fauci said long before that he changed his mind that, you know, masks, they're not really that effective. And then the person at 60 Minutes says, are you sure? A lot of people are going to hear about this. You don't want to take back what you said. And Fauci said, no, I mean, they're not really that effective. I mean, they might block some little droplets here and there, but, you know, they're not really that effective. And that is true. You got to understand this, is that mask, okay, if you think that they're that effective, then we don't need vaccines and we don't need all these kind of procedures. The reason why they added that mask is because better than nothing. That's the reason why. But they do know this, it's not really that effective. It's not going to solve the virus issue. It doesn't, all right? It doesn't solve the virus issue. And don't get me wrong, I get the idea of mask better than no mask. I get that. And they have scientific papers coming out with that one. But look, you have to also think about, even if you do a double mask, what are you going to do? You're going to fidget the mask more? Then what are you going to do? Touch the mask? I mean, look, one mask is good enough where you're fixing it. But if you have double mask, that's even worse. You're telling me you're not going to touch your face even more after that? I thought we're not supposed to touch our face even. By the way, this is even better. CNBC, in the same article that I quoted, Triple mask. You know why I'm angry about this? Because this is so ridiculous. Why not do four masks then? Five masks? Because if you put 10 masks on, it is definitely more effective. If we're using common sense, right? Come on, let's follow that logic. Isn't that common sense? So this is, you know why they're not gonna go that far? I'll tell you why they're not gonna go that far. Because it's ridiculous. So far, let's do double masks because we're used to wearing the ridiculous masks. So we're conditioned to that. So maybe we can condition to a little bit more ridiculousness. So let's do double mask. CNBC is so daring. Triple mask. Double mask efficiency 75%. Triple mask efficiency 90%. I hear some people going even higher than that.
Wow.
I mean, I told you, there are epidemiologists. I gave their articles. I even, in the last End Times and Demons video study, I mentioned about, I keep messing up his last name, Jay Bhattacharya from Stanford, and they had a peer-reviewed journal talking about that mask mandates, that they're not effective, that there are better methods to do this. All right, this has gotten, because why? You can't just think about, I get it, scientifically speaking, you're only thinking about what's the best option against the virus. But you can't solely have a limited, narrow-minded perspective like that. There's a huge deal that you're ignoring that Scott Atlas mentioned, and that is referring to the economy. He mentioned not just people's health lives, but basically economic lives. Because people commit suicide. People are becoming jobless. And if you become jobless and homeless, aren't you more prone to the virus out there, etc.? So you got to think about all this kind of stuff. See? So that's very narrow-minded. So you have to think in a holistic perspective on what's best for society. Because look at how bad it's gotten. When you have a narrow-minded point of view, this is what you get. Title of the article from BBC News. COVID. Women fined for going for a walk. And guess what happened? Received police apology. Yeah, man. Oh, boy. Didn't you know that it's illegal to play snowballs? They're trying to say, do not go outside and play snowballs. Didn't you know they even say that? I kid you not. That's what's going on in Happy Merry England out there. Happy Merry England out there. They mentioned that you can't even do snowballs out there. Oh, it's so sad. Title of the article, and this is from, let's see here, Telegraph. This is from the Telegraph, all right? Title of their article, snowball fights will get you a 200-pound, I think that's the monetary value, 200-pound COVID fine.
Wow.
Telegraph, all right? I try to read what is mainstream and what is even liberal. And I go through scholastic sources. I try to do that throughout this entire time. You see that, right? So I try to do that. COVID has gotten to a point where it's so bad and ridiculous. I'm telling you what. Concerning about vaccines, Sweden wants clarity now. Title of the article from Reuters, Sweden wants clarity on vaccine doses before paying Pfizer. Why? Because they're having trouble with money issues. Now, this is the interesting thing. Before I go back to Reuters' article about Sweden, interestingly, this is from Biopharma Drive, so they concentrate on this scientific aspect. Title of their article is Merck Stops Coronavirus Vaccine Development in Surprise Setback. So Merck, I don't know if you know this, but these are the guys who are very leading concerning about vaccines. Well, why aren't they a big name coming out then? Why is it Pfizer, Moderna, AstraZeneca, etc.? What happened to Merck? Because Merck, if you actually read that article, they were actually skeptical. Long time ago, they were skeptical about the methods. mRNA, they didn't rely on that route. They wanted to go for a more, I'm not sure the scientific terminology, but I guess a more genuine natural route to take care of the virus. I don't know if I'm saying that correctly. But the point is that they don't rely on the mRNA method that the other big vaccine leading organizations today are doing. But it's surprising that Merck would fall behind. Why? Because they themselves were skeptical about that. They were skeptical about it early coming out that fast through this method. Wonder why? Wonder why? Are there scientific reasons for that one? Maybe there are scientific reasons now then about just the quick rush method of pushing out these vaccines. Unless Merck was stupid. Maybe they were all stupid. Maybe they weren't scientifically thinking. Maybe they're just being idiotic and these guys should all be fired. So Merck, they're switching now to mRNA, if I recall now, because now they've fallen so far behind. So because they've fallen so far behind in vaccine, a lot of people want it. I think now they're switching toward an mRNA approach finally now. But back then, they had some kind of rightful skepticism to them. That's how they felt like. They said also because of the demands of the people, that's a huge issue. The huge issue was the demands of the people and how much money concerning each dosage, per vial, etc. And guess what? It did happen. I don't know if you're looking, but Europe, they're struggling right now. I mean, they're angry. Title of the article from The Economist, delays in COVID-19 vaccine delivery are causing tempers to flare and timetables to slip. Now these companies are eating up the consequences of what they've sown. You reap what you sow. So sure, you want to get it out. You want to help out a lot of people. But another troubling thing about pharma, if you're going to be very honest about it, is that pharma, they do, and I studied in liberal schools, all right? They even say this too about their clients, okay? Is that everything is money. Everything is money, money, money. So getting these out real quick, I mean, they've just eaten and reaped what they've sown. So now they have to deal with that. So I don't know how they're going to deal with this issue, but Europe is mad and they're fighting against one of the big leading vaccine companies. So I forgot to look through inside that article, but I think it's AstraZeneca or one of those companies. But here is one of the European countries, Sweden, right? So let's go back to Sweden, exactly what's going on. So you now know the background of what's going on. The background of what's going on is they're having trouble with the demands of the people. So they have to get these vaccines out. Sweden, the clarity it wants is concerning about, quote, Sweden's health agency is seeking clarification from the European Union on how many COVID-19 vaccine doses per vial it has to pay Pfizer for and is hoping for an answer before payments fall due in a few weeks. You know what's interesting? How many doses per vial from the vaccine? Pfizer has charged for 6 doses per vial. Ooh, 6. Like 6, 6, and 6 maybe? You know, one of these pastors, I'm not going to mention his name, but one of these pastors that I talked to, he told me that that their city or the officials in charge of their district mentioned to them when they have singing that you got to be 13 feet apart. And then the pastor's like, who came up with that number? Who's the idiot who came up with that number? Ha, ha, ha. We did, you know. reliable government did. You know, it's so funny is that every time we study about the things that's going on with vaccines and the COVID situation, for some weird reason, it always ties to the dreadful fears of the Christians who talked about the mark of the beast coming out with 666. And now we've got conditioned and normalized to be 6 feet apart now, right? I'll tell you what. Now, you can't ban me for saying this, all right? You can't ban me for saying don't be 6 feet apart. Why don't you be 7 feet apart? I mean, that extra foot, it's common sense, right? I'm trying to think like Fauci. Isn't it common sense that an extra feet would be extra safe? Maybe you guys don't want to do that because you know how inconvenient that is and ridiculous. Oh, boy. I got to be careful now because now I'm going to get kicked out real soon. You know what's going on? Business Insider, title of their article. Twitter's new birdwatch feature will let users to sift through and add notes to misleading tweets. Yeah. So this is anybody that they themselves can pick. So then what? So then if the Snopes guy or some kind of liberal who has an agenda against Christians, if these guys are like known as, we'll point out and we'll do the fact check, then they might just let them in and then have them just say, oh, so this preacher said this, this preacher said that. And by the way, they're doing that to me right now. But the reason why that we're able to stand is because I know this liberal area, and then I look at the procedures and I try to follow along as best as I can. But they've been trying to give out report and report all the time, these wicked evil trolls. And guess what? If you give them power now, that's even problematic. Yeah. Now you're giving them power. We won't last for long. Well, they might be fair. No, they're not fair. You know why? Mark Dice tried, all right? Mark Dice, he says, so I wanted to be a fact checker too, so I signed up to be the bird watcher in Twitter. That's what they call it, these bird watchers, that they're hiring to fact check people. And guess what he says in his video, which is titled Already? If you look at his YouTube channel, they rejected him, which is obvious. Why? Because he just wanted to fact check the mainstream news. Why? Someone's got to keep tabs on these guys. Don't mainstream news make mistakes? Yes, they do. Project Veritas caught them a lot of times. So then what are they going to do about that? Oh, they're not fair. They themselves have the power to pick what they want to pick. Remember, social networks is going on a launch. It's really bad. Social networks, they're hunting. They're hunting people. Parler had that incident that happened where a lot of companies are not accepting them. And I've given that explanation to you in previous End Times and Demons video. So they're hunting, guys. They're hunting. Our time is about to come. We got to pray for that rapture to happen real quick, right? You know how bad this is? If you look at Mark Dice's video already, it's so bad that he mentioned that even his facial expression of what he did against a certain group, if you just go to Google, it's called face crime. And you're like, well, are you serious? Yeah, because if you give a certain facial expression about a group that you don't like, and let me do this before YouTube bans me. Let me say the right word for YouTube. Trumpers. Oh, those Trumpers. Oh, those Trumpers. Let's see YouTube ban me after that. So that's considered a hate face crime toward a certain group because they're just persecuted and hurt so much. I kid you not, and you can look that video. By the way, in that same video you look, he proved shadow banning. Because when you type down Mark Dice on Twitter, his name didn't pop out, but his fans who took his name, they popped out. It was so weird. So his name didn't even pop out. Then what was even more funny is after he mentioned that on his video, next time Twitter, when you type down Mark Dice, next time Twitter, they put his name at the top page of search. Isn't that funny? Why? Because maybe they got caught. Twitter maybe got caught. Same thing maybe like YouTube, because I don't know if it's still going on, but back then, when you typed down my name, it was all the critics trying to debunk me. And then my other videos, what? They got way thousands of more views. Now that you type my name, it got back. So I wonder what happened. I wonder what happened. Can you believe that? I gotta be careful. careful when I preach now. See that? I'm not going to, one day we're not going to last long. I preach some kind of against some kind of sin or sinner and give some kind of face crime. Let me give the right face crime so that they don't kick me out. If I give the right face toward a certain sinner I don't like, then they're going to ban me one day. You see how wicked and evil these people are? It's so messed up, man. We're not safe anymore, guys. Title of the article from Newsweek. And they're known to be leaning toward the left. Title of the article from Newsweek is Agent Fired from Literary Agency for Using Parler and Gab. Wow. Here's another one. You know what they're allowing? This is so messed up. Now these guys are getting more bold on Twitter, the liberal guys. While the people who are calling out something that's Christian or conservative, etc., etc., these guys have less to speak now. While the left wing, they can be more bold and bold in speech. They gotten so bold as to say in one CNN article titled, Planned Parenthood deletes tweet, why? For being so bold, calling for a Disney princess who's had an abortion. These wicked Planned Parenthood people, I don't know if you knew this, but they're influencing Hollywood now. And Hollywood has gotten ridiculous movies and shows where like they're condoning about women power, where women feel so empowered in getting the abortion. And like, it's a great thing. And they've gotten so far now to put this stupid tweet saying that we should have a Disney princess for the children to watch who went through an abortion as a good role model. And then you know why the person deleted the tweet? Obvious, not because Twitter thought it was hate speech. You know why? Because so many people were writing negative stuff on it. Like, this is so messed up. All these people complain. Man, that's messed up. We've gotten to such a great day, haven't we? I mean, ever since Biden became president, we've gotten such a great day and things are getting better. And now that the hateful Trump is gone, I mean, the world would become a much more humane, Jesus-loving place, right? One person complained, so glad Planned Parenthood deleted their disgusting tweet. I don't really think having a Disney princess getting an abortion is appropriate for young girls. Yeah, isn't that obvious? Oh, man. Planned Parenthood Keystone head Melissa Reed confirmed that her group did send the tweet. Same CNN article that I just read. This is the article about the safety subcommittee who investigated about the vaccines happening to the frail elderly people, especially the incident that happened at Norway. And unless I'm looking at the wrong article, because I'm trying to find their attachments, I would like more information. I'm even looking at it. World Health Organization, title of the article, GACVS COVID-19 Vaccine Safety Subcommittee meeting to review reports of deaths of very frail elderly individuals vaccinated with Pfizer BioNTech COVID-19 vaccine, BNT162B2. Now look, maybe they do have scientific explanations and it's okay to take the vaccine. Maybe they can say that. But me, look, if I'm thinking about my elderly family members and my own life, and then I hear about these things happening, I do have a right to be concerned. Yeah. And isn't that the goal of science? Is that it's supposed to try to go through methods that are provable. They say it can't be proved, but that you can critique. Yeah. Otherwise, it's not a solid scientific method. So sometimes people don't think about that. What happened at Biden's inauguration? Things must have gotten better, right? Well, let's go back to the abortion area. Oh, by the way, our Twitter account, guess what happened? We lost, if I'm incorrect, then the sister can correct me, but we lost thousands of followers on our Twitter. You know why? Ever since because of the Trump riot stuff. Wow, they're marching on. And I was even condemning the riots that happened. Didn't you hear me say that? Wow. campusreform.org, that's a really good site that I'd recommend, because this website, they go through higher education authorities and they look at that perspective while having a conservative type of mindset. So if you want those kind of articles, I'd recommend that site. But they mentioned this article that was disturbing. Title of the article, Sociologist Calls for More Abortion-Based Comedy. See, they're influencing Hollywood. People got frustrated and mad that in BBC News, title of their article, COVID, Rexham vaccine production resumes after suspect package. In other words, it looked like someone planted a bomb over there. So there's a lot. See, this is bad. The public's getting mad and scared and concerned. So it's your job that you have to give the information out to people, not build up the suspicion and ban and hide. When you do that, you're making the people more angry. That's not making our society even better. The vaccine, I mean, we're not far away, folks. Title of the news from LifeSite, Biden executive order. What is this executive order? Directs government to evaluate feasibility of vaccine passports. Remember about the stuff that you've heard from long time ago when I mentioned to you, and you've heard probably from other sources where people are concerned about the mark of the beast, where, hey, remember about that immunity passport? And to prove that in order for you to take a flight that you did take the vaccine, otherwise then you can't travel out. Get ready, man. Get ready. So they're going to require that. And I pray that it, hopefully it won't happen, but it looks like they might happen. It might happen. By the way, concerning speaking of face, where people have to confirm your identity and then you'll need a vaccine passport and etc. And then, God forbid, but it might come down to a point where traveling preachers, if you're going to have to travel, or a missionary, man, you're going to have to go through that. So government is taking control more and more, as you can see, where people's information and keeping track of people, it's not as so private as before back then. It's not as private as 100 years ago. They're now keeping more and more track. This is from FacePay. Their video is FacePay, building India's first face recognition-based payments. Wait a minute. Revelation 13, you buy and sell with a mark in your forehead, right? Now they're having this facial recognition where you can pay through that. Oh, wait a minute. We're already doing something with this one, right? Face identity. And then imagine, I mean, you can make big business from this. Wouldn't it be great if Apple combined that with your credit card payments and etc.? And maybe it'll be more feasible if we combine that with health issues, somehow combine the health issue with keeping immunity passports or information, with buying and selling, all of that combined through this one. Wouldn't that be awesome one day, guys? I mean, we're doing thumbs for now, fingers for now too, right? You thought that Bible was stupid, right? Buying and selling using the right hand or through the forehead, something that has to do with your hands or your face. You thought that they were stupid, weren't they? You thought the Bible was stupid. People are stupid. That's the thing. And then everyone was so scared about the Trump riots. They never mentioned about Antifa. I mean, you know what happened when during Biden's inauguration? Where were the Trump rioters that time, you know? And then you called out the guard, and then now the guard, after the inauguration is over, you basically left them out, quote unquote, thankfully not, to die, but that's what you basically did. You just left them alone, all rotting. But title of the article from Reuters, anti-fascist protesters vandalized buildings in Portland and Seattle. And this happened, here's from Wall Street Journal. Inauguration Day protest in Portland. Seattle turned violent. ABC 7 News. Antifa finds no one to fight in California Capitol on Inauguration Day. I thought they hired the people to protect from Trump rioters, right? But where is the mainstream news about Antifa? They yak their mouth for weeks in, weeks out, article after article, hours and hours of culmination about Trump rioters, Trump rioters. What about Antifa? What about Antifa? Well, Fox News, they actually told you the totality of their news on that one, which is so stinking funny. If you actually look at, so I don't have the article here, but if you actually look at Fox News, what they mention about the combined news about what the liberal news media reported on Antifa, it's a culmination of a minute, less under a minute, of all three liberal news media outlets about the Antifa riots. One of them, if I recall from memory, 20 seconds or 10 seconds. Wow, you see this, man? You see this? People are saying, you're trying to justify Trump riots. I'm sick and tired of you guys saying that. Shut up, all right? I've already got enough people who's for Trump who got mad at me about condemning about the Trump riots. So why don't you shut up about that? Probably you're an atheist troll in disguise. Or maybe you're just a gullible Christian who don't know better, and you should know better. You should be ashamed of yourself. Don't I have the right to criticize anything wrong out there? And you know who's dominating the platform of wrongs right now? I point out the conservatives, obviously I do, and you see that throughout my other videos, but who's dominating the platform of wrongs more, if you're going to be very honest, are these stinking liberals right now. Mm-hmm. So whatever pops in my mind in the mainstream news, who does the wrong action first, you betcha I'm going to call them out. Anyways, by the way, did you type down Antifa.com before? Did you all try that one before? Yeah, if you type down Antifa.com, it goes to the front page picture of the WhiteHouse.gov with Joe Biden at the front page. I kid you not. I don't know if they still change that. Some of you can try that right now. Just type down Antifa.com, all right? But that did happen. So a lot of the Joe Biden's... office and a lot of people, they got upset and they were like trying to deny it. They're like saying, we weren't involved in that one, you know? So it was pretty funny.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Change.
Still up there. They didn't fix that. Wow.
Oh, yeah.
How about that? Well, anyways, some of you onliners are probably doing that now, or you've heard about that already. Now, this is, remember about people are worried about artificial intelligence when the Antichrist comes out with his idol that speaks, an animated object? Title of the article from Reuters, don't forget her, Sophia. Makers of Sophia the Robot plan mass rollout amid pandemic. That's just a little bit closer to the Great Reset, the World Economic Forum, about depending upon technology to carry the food and delivering things for you. Not far away. Andy Nguo, he points out, if you look at his videos, he done a really good job, but he's getting terrorized by Antifa, so he had to run away and stuff like that. But if you look at his Twitter right now, he'll point you case after case of Antifa, what they've been doing after the inauguration, of what happened at Tacoma, etc. These guys were, I mean, where was the news, liberal news media, when Antifa was shaking, trying to break free the prison bars so that the prisoners can go free? Where were they on that? Where was the mainstream news when Antifa went inside a federal building? Where were they? Oh, they don't mention too much about that. And then you catch them on their hypocrisy, these liberal Portland politicians, and then they get away with it. Title of the article, this is from the Post-Millennial. Title of the article, Portland Mayor Ted Wheeler pepper sprays man who confronted him over not wearing a mask. Remember how many times these liberal politicians were caught dining when they mentioned that you shouldn't be dining, or you know, they went out traveling when they shouldn't be traveling, or not wearing a mask, and they broke the rules about the limited numbers of people. Now this guy, I guess, couldn't take anymore, and he just had to pepper spray a guy. You know what his excuse was? I was afraid that guy would infect me.
Wow.
Then where was your mask then, you fool?
Yeah.
Idiot. This is, if you look at CBS and in the title, in their 60 Minutes video, they have, you can find this easily if you Google it, but when they're going through the interview process with Joe Biden, he mentioned about the judiciary is getting out of whack. Now, why is that important? Because everybody was scared when he gave that quote about setting up a what you call a commission or a board or whatever. Because if you look at what's going on at the White House, Democrats got it now. The House, the Democrats got it. The Senate, Democrats got it. And you're so scared and you're like, man, if they take everything over, then this is like pretty much the end of the world, especially if you get one of these people proposing about changing names and titles of people. Mm-hmm. So then it turns, the leftover is judicial power now. Because of what Trump did at the last minute, that's why we're still surviving. But now if you get Democrats to fill out the seats of judicial power, it's game over. How do you do that? We just have to add more seats. So guess what? He started to push that now. Title the article from Politico, Biden starts staffing a commission on Supreme Court reform. So now he's starting to do that. And if you actually look at that article, it's going to go up to 9 to, I think, between 9 and 15 members they're discussing. So get ready, guys. Get ready. Oh, by the way, Biden was caught breaking his own mandate about in the federal grounds, we should be wearing masks. But guess what? He was caught not doing that, him and his family. So here's a video from Fox News. Peter Ducey presses, what's her name? Psaki? Psaki? Is that right? Psaki? Whatever. All right, sack her. But Psaki on why Biden didn't wear a mask on federal land. All right? And then you know what she was doing? Well, there are more important things and stuff like that. Look, this is the president of the United States who did an executive order. And if he breaks his own rule, then what's the difference with the communist leader dictating a rule for equality of the people? We have to have equality rights of the people. But I can break my own rule, says the communist leader back then in history. These people are something else. I know that I've gone over the time, which I apologize. If some of you need to get going, please feel free to get going because I probably might spend about 5 to 10 more minutes, but I'll try to wrap this up quickly because there's just so much news of what happened now ever since Biden got inaugurated. So it's gotten so big to a point that it's gotten big. So to the personal essential staff who is over here, you can feel free to leave anytime about that. So let me wrap this up quickly with a few people who are in this room. Helping me out with the work, with our online ministry, amen? All right, so this is from Breitbart, and they actually pulled up the documents, so you can look it up yourself. They pulled out the documents from Washington Post and all these other news sources. So this is a real guy. This is very real scholars, which is becoming very worrisome. And these are anti-Trump scholars. From Breitbart, anti-Trump scholar, quote, nearly impossible to deprogram millions of Trump supporters. If you read the articles from all these anti-Trump scholars, it's very disturbing and scary. You might say, why is it? Because these people actually say that these people are so down the Trump rabbit hole and believe the conspiracies, and they're tying Christians to this. They're now tying Christians to this, and they're saying that this has gotten so worrisome that it's gotten to a point of impossibility to deprogram these people. Why, then what are you going to resort to now, right? This is scary. So they're trying to develop some kind of more brainwashing methods, and some liberals were caught saying that we should set up camps for these people and education programs. It's scary, guys. It's scary. One day we're going to hit over there. And the Trump people, obviously, they're getting crucified one by one. And Dominion, they amped up their defamation suit. Title of the article from The Hill, Dominion Voting Systems files $1.3 billion defamation suit against Giuliani. Oh, come on. You have to raise it that high. Really? Really? You got enough news media covering for you guys, don't you? I mean, is it that bad and that serious? Maybe because you guys aren't really explaining yourselves to the people as much as you should, even though you said that you tried, but you haven't done a good job on that one. Biden, things are getting better? Well, remember the liberals, they complained about Bush, the conservatives, getting involved in the Iraq war. Well, AP News, title of the article, Biden, Syria withdrawal proves Trump is a complete failure. So guess what? He's putting troops back in there, in Syria. And then where do you hear the news media? You know, aren't they very quiet? This is why Breaking Defense News, they mentioned, which has gotten serious, title of their article, Israelis say they'll attack Iran if U.S. eases sanctions. Why? Because they're afraid about Iran building up their bombs. And now that Biden became president, they're less worried, right? No, they're more worried. Because they're really wondering what's going on behind the scene. China, be careful, we're becoming more dependent upon these guys now. Title of the article, this is from a pro-Chinese source, all right, pro-Chinese news source, Global Times. Tesla, Apple to source growth from increasing reliance on China, says the analyst. Title of their article. If you look at the video about people moving away from California, it's bad. Yeah. Moving to Texas and then Elon Musk as well. So then a lot of the California, I'm talking about California scholars were saying, this is really bad. You need to amp up your game. You know why? Oh, I wonder, because you're so stinking liberal, California, maybe that's why?
Yeah.
Pushing these policies that's being hard for the businesses. Now, I don't think, look, you thought that this was crazy, right? Everything leading to chips and 666. And I know that there is no proof about tying to the chips with the vaccines yet, but me, I still see it as a yet. I think in time, you're going to somehow connect it one way or another. So it doesn't necessarily have to be where it goes inside your bloodstream. It can be something else. But the point is this. The point is that, I don't know if you knew this, but if you look this up, there's a YouTube video titled China Develops Test Chip for Multiple Respiratory Viruses. This is by china.org.cn. Test chip for multiple respiratory viruses approved. You know when? Last year. So guess what The Economist says? The Economist titles their article, this is not just connected to health issues where you're tying chips. It's everything now. Title of the article from The Economist, The Struggle Over Chips Enters a New Phase. The age of their manufacturer in China could be beginning. They might take the full frontal force now. Revelation 13, please, and let's call it a night. So let's total all these articles together when we look at Revelation 13, and then I bid you good night. Look at Revelation chapter 13. Look at all this. This is, all of this is just fulfilling right in front of our eyes in one chapter. One chapter. Look how this goes. Verse 2. And the beast which I saw, that's the Antichrist, the king and his kingdom, which I saw was like unto a leopard, and his feet were as the feet of a bear, and his mouth as the mouth of a lion. And the dragon gave him his power and his seat and great authority. What is the leopard? That's the United States of America. What's the feet? That's referring to Russia. However, Russia moves, and a lot of people say communism died out in Russia. No, come on, grow up. You know, even Democrat politicians are talking about Russian propaganda, Russian government, you know, having socialist, communist leanings. But getting back to the point, the job of the United States of America for the Antichrist is that it has to move like the socialistic, if not communistic, movements of Russia. So China is definitely considered communism. So look how America is leaning now, leaning toward China. And they're taking over the economy now. And now with chips? That's scary. Especially they've been doing something like this from last year. Continuing on. Look at verse 14, and deceiveth them that dwell on the earth by the means of those miracles which he had power to do in the sight of the beast, saying to them that dwell on the earth that they should make an image to the beast which had the wound by a sword and did live, and he had power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause that as many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed. Look what they're doing. World Economic Forum. Great reset, relying on technology, Sophia that a lot of people were worried about before, artificial intelligence, etc. taking advantage during the pandemic situation. And then lastly, verse 16, and he causeth all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their foreheads, and that no man might buy or sell save he that had the mark or the name of the beast or the number of his name. You can't, buying and selling is now tied to hand and face. And they have to have information on you too. That's what verse 17 shows. They need to have the information to prove to them. So then with the vaccination passports and then all the executive orders, it's just beginning, friend. It's just beginning. And then you get a crazy number where they mention about 6 feet apart. And then with the weird stuff that happened at Sweden with 6 doses per vial. And then the Bible mentions about a vial poured out upon those which have the mark of the beast, 666. Yeah. Wow. So I don't know why God did that. Why did God deliberately word it that way? Is he seeing something deliberately at the future we don't know about? That's why verse 18, 6 is the number. Verse 18. Good night. Yeah. Let's close with a word of prayer. God, my Father, I pray that tonight's teachings were a blessing to the hearers. Dismiss us now with your blessing. And I pray that during these dangerous times, you'll protect your church and that your word will continue to spread. People will get saved before it's too late. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.